In this Stripe tutorial, we'll be creating coupon codes with different set of rules. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, then please like and subscribe to my channel, which will keep me motivated in creating more helpful videos for you. Alright, this is the dashboard and they have changed the layout a little bit. Previously, the sidebar items were available at the top. But now they have moved these to the left side. Anyways, to create a coupon, click on More and navigate to Product Catalog. Here you will see all your available products. If you don't know how to add products, then I've explained that in the part 1 of this Stripe tutorial, so check that out if you need. You can find the link in the description. Alright, go to the Coupons tab and here you can manage all your coupons. Click on Create a Coupon and you have some settings here. First, you can name your coupon. This will appear on the customer receipts and invoices. I'll put friendly discount just for the demonstration. You can skip the ID field as Stripe recommends to leave this blank. Next, you have two types of discounts. You can either choose a fixed amount discount and put your discounted amount here regardless of the product total price. Or you can choose the percentage discount and set a specific percentage of the total amount. If you want to apply this coupon to specific products, you can do that here. I'm gonna choose this product and let's choose another one. Next, you can select the duration of your coupon. I'll keep it to forever. Redemption limits allows you to limit when a customer can redeem the coupon and the number of times a coupon can be used. You can set an expiry date and time for the coupon. I'll set it to 22 February. And you can also limit the total number of times this coupon can be used. Let's say 20 times. Next, you'll have to turn this on so you can generate codes that you can provide to your customers. Here you can type your desired code. You can type whatever you want and this code is case sensitive, so keep that in mind. Then you have some other options to set a criteria for this coupon to work. Eligible for first time means that this code will only be eligible for customers who have never made a purchase before. Limit to a specific customer allows only your selected customers to use this code. You can limit the number of times this code can be used. You can add an expiry date to the coupon. And you can also set a criteria of minimum amount for the code to work. And you can create more than one code with a different set of rules. I want this code to be anytime 20. I don't want to limit this for the first time purchases only. And I don't want this to be used only by some specific customers. But I want this code to be only used 5 times. You can set an expiry date. But if you notice, I can't select a date beyond 22. Because in the above settings, I've set the expiration date to 22 February, so it's following that rule. If I want to select a date beyond 22 here, then I'll have to change it in the above settings first. And now I can select it here as well. Alright, let's create another one with some different rules. I'll call this one Friendly 20. I want this code to limit to 25 times. I'll set a minimum budget of $500 for this code to be applicable. Now if I click on Create Coupon, then it's gonna show me an error here. Cause above, we set the maximum limit for this code to 20 times. So it's following that rule. If I change it to 30 times, then this error should be resolved. Alright, we have created 3 codes, each with a different set of rules. And you can add more codes if you want. After that, click on Create Coupon. And that's it. You can see the coupon name, terms, redemption limit, and the expiry date here. If I click on it, here are my codes, and you can see the usage of each code separately. If you want to delete a coupon, then just click on these 3 dots and hit delete coupon. So that's the end of this video. In the next part, I'll show you how to create and send an invoice. So make sure to check the next part. I'll put the links in the description. If this video was helpful, then please like and subscribe to my channel so I can keep on making more helpful videos for you. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.